In this webcast, I want to cover some of the chemistry of the coenzyme acetyl-CoA, but don't be confused, it's not the biochemistry that I'm interested in. I really want you to focus on the organic transformations, recognizing that the biochemistry that takes place is the result of organic transformations that you've already encountered. So, for example, in the synthesis of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, whose structure is shown here, it's the result of a substitution reaction that takes place at the thioester of acetyl-CoA. Don't be confused. In fact, this really takes place by a two-step sequence, the addition followed by the beta elimination step. So, nucleophile addition, the nucleophile is the oxygen of this hydroxyl group of choline, to the polarized pi bond, the carbonyl group of the thioester. That generates a tetrahedral intermediate. You should be able to write that tetrahedral intermediate. That tetrahedral intermediate collapses by a beta elimination process to eliminate the thiol group of coenzyme A and the new ester bond of acetylcholine. This substitution reaction is fairly straightforward. The second sequence of transformations is a little more complicated. It's the biosynthesis of the 5-carbon atom building block mevalonic acid. That structure is shown here. Mevalonic acid is the intermediate that is involved in terpene synthesis. Terpenes are the familiar flavors of fruit and the fragrances of plants like the pine needle aroma. The synthesis of mevalonic acid involves two molecules of coenzyme A coming together in a Claisen condensation. So one molecule of coenzyme A is deprotonated at its alpha position. This looks like an enolate anion. This nucleophile does nucleophile addition to the polarized pi bond, the carbonyl, of a second molecule of CoA. That generates a tetrahedral intermediate. You should be able to draw that tetrahedral intermediate. It does a beta elimination, eliminating the thiol group of coenzyme A, and generates this beta-ketoester. It's catalyzed by an enzyme known as beta-ketoacylthiolase. That's a Claisen-type condensation that you should have seen before and be familiar with now. The second example, the second reaction, involves the Aldo reaction. It's a special type of Aldo reaction known as the Reformatsky reaction. The enolate is generated by this thioester that is also derived from coenzyme A. Decarboxylation, and you should show the curved arrows, would generate an enolate, much like the enolate that you see here. So go ahead and think about that enolate. That nucleophile does an addition to this carbonyl group, so nucleophile addition to a polarized pi bond. That creates this new tetrahedral center here. So just to keep track of things, you should recognize that this methyl group is the methyl group shown there. The oxygen atom of the carbonyl is the hydroxyl group here. Decarboxylation took place. This carbonyl group was lost. That's where the CO2 came from. And also what happened is, in this reaction, the thiol ester was hydrolyzed to the carboxylic acid. Those are the transformations that took place in this Aldo-Reformatsky-type reaction. I haven't shown you the full set of curved arrows, but I suspect that you'd be able to draw those out for yourself. What happens next is a reduction reaction. So remember, the reduction reaction involves the addition of hydride, and that transforms the thioester group into the hydroxyl group. So there's been an addition of hydrogen atoms in this position for what used to be the carbonyl group. So those are the overall steps in the biosynthesis of mevalonic acid, and you can see that acetyl-CoA plays a key role in each of these transformations.